going to the fair with us. He has to wear a collar. See? I'm wearing one. And a leash, too. Now, that leash is hanging right up here. Oh, here it is. Lassie! Lassie, where are you? Lassie! Come out, wherever you are. You gotta wear your collar and leash. They won't let you in without it.
Timmy, we're ready to leave.
Lassie's hiding because she doesn't want to wear her collar and leash.
That's because she's a farm dog. They like to be free.
Okay, girl. We'll just have to go without you.
I guess we'll have to leave Lassie home.
You know we wouldn't leave you home after I promised you you'd go with us. And you don't have to wear your collar and leash until you get there. And I don't have to wear this leash until I get there.
What's keeping you? Lassie's getting impatient. Is everything locked up?
Tight as a drum.
Good.
I hope Seth is ready. We're getting a late start as it is. He's been having a lot of trouble with that truck of his. I told him last week he ought to get it overhauled.
Well, I'm glad we can take him.
Everybody.
Hi, Seth.
Hello, Seth.
I was just fixing up some new roosts.
Are those prize leghorns you're planning to buy?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to getting some beauties. Where's Uncle Petrie?
Oh, he left for the fair at the crack of dawn to help Irv Simmons with his prize hogs.
How's Bertha?
Oh, fine. She's in the kitchen. Just made a batch of cookies for us to take along. Well, hi, Lassie. You going to the fair, too? Too bad she won't be able to go inside.
But she's going to wear her collar and leash.
Well, didn't you hear about the new law? No dogs allowed on the fairgrounds on account of some trouble they had the last time. Too many dogs or something.
You'll have a nice ride anyway. You can wait in the car for us. And you won't have to wear your collar and leash after all.
I'll tell Bertha that you're here. Bertha, the Martins are here.
Oh, just in time. I was getting some cookies ready for them.
They've got Lassie along.
Well, didn't they know that dogs are not allowed on the fairgrounds?
I guess not. I just told them.
Mom, can I go in and see Mrs. Collins' menagerie? Do you know what I mean?
Yes, menagerie.
Yeah, that's right. Zoo. She showed it to me once. Her sister owns a pet shop, and she sends Mrs. Collins all the sick ones because she's so good at taking care of them.
Yes, I know. I think it's a good idea if we all go in to see Bertha.
How would it be if Lassie stayed here with you? Then she wouldn't have to be cooped up in the car all afternoon.
Oh, I'd like to, Seth. But keeping a dog around all those pets, even a dog as nice as Lassie, might scare them to death.
Well, you get that tied up and ready to go. I'll pick some fruit to take along. Mm-hmm.
Shake hands. Look, Lassie, a duck. And there's a rabbit. And a parrot.
Cracker.
No, but I've got a dog biscuit. They make a lot of noise, don't they?
Gracious me, what's going on here? Lassie, what are you doing?
What did she do, Mrs. Collins?
Well, she's scaring my birds and all the other animals, too. Can't you hear?
Well, Lassie wouldn't hurt them. She's a good dog.
Lassie, good dog.
See? They're just saying hello, aren't they, Mom?
How nice to see you again, Bertha.
Well, don't you folks look wonderful?
We've come to get your man.
He went to get some fruit. And I baked some cookies for you to take along.
Oh, that's nice.
Mrs. Collins?
Oh, yes, what?
Is that a new pet?
Oh, yes.
your mama's baby, pretty chipper.
A real monkey.
No, he's a baby chip, and he was a sick one, too. Right at death's door, he was. But he's getting over that nasty old pneumonia, aren't you, Chippy baby? Yeah.
Give me a kiss.
Yes, that's right.
She fusses more over this one than she does over me.
Now you hush, Seth Collins. I won't have you hurting Chipper's feelings.
It's all right. Lassie wouldn't do anything to him.
Oh, of course she wouldn't. Nor to any of your other pets either. I think they'd get along just fine.
Well, maybe they do with that. See, I have an idea. Lassie wouldn't have any fun being locked up in a hot car all day. Now, why don't you leave her here with me?
Well, that's very thoughtful of you, Bertha.
Well, how about it, Timmy? Lassie will have lots of company.
How about it, Lassie?
Gracious, what did she say?
Yes, I think.
Then it's all right, Bertha?
Oh, of course. Once he gets those fancy roosters to fuss over, he won't be so quick to tease me about Chipper.
At least a chicken's good for something.
Sit down and talk.
Come on, we've got a long drive ahead of us.
You be a good dog. And do everything Mrs. Collins says to you. Okay?
Okay.
He talks pretty well.
Ah, pretty chipper, or your mama's baby, pretty chipper. Ah.
Pretty well. Too well.
Bye-bye, Bertha. Thanks very
much.
Bye. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Well, now, baby chipper, you better get back in your cage and take a nice little nap. Of course, we don't want you to get sick again, huh?
Pretty bye, or your pretty baby. Pretty bye.
Huh?
Or your pretty baby. Pretty bye. Pretty bye.
That's right. Go to Betty Bye.
Oh, your pretty baby.
Quiet, Chatterbox. You want to see, too? Well, those are fan tails. Are they pretty? And these are parakeets. And these furry things are hamsters. Don't you think they're cute? And this is Billy. Billy, how about a little song for Lassie? Come on. And over here, well, this is a minor bird. He comes from India. How about a whistle, Pete? Huh?
Can you talk? Can you talk?
Now, Chipper, don't tell me that you're getting jealous of Lassie. You're still Mommy's baby, don't you know that?
Mommy's baby.
Oh, my goodness. Time for your oatmeal. Maybe that's why you're fussing. Lassie. That's right. Lie down. Be a good dog.
Here.
I'll get it right away. Just a minute.
Hurry back, Chipper. get the case locked, Chipper.
What's going on? Lassie! Good gracious, Lassie. What have you done? All tangled up like this. There's enough room under there for two dogs. You've been in the house before. You ought to be able to behave better than this. Well, that's a good girl. Now you lie down there and keep out of trouble. You all right, baby? Goodness, your oatmeal. Oh, my. I'll get it right away. Now, Lassie, you understand. You behave till I get back.
You can come out now, Chipper.
Chipper? Chipper?
He must have gotten out of his cage. It wasn't you at all. Goodness, we've got to do something. I'm sorry I was nasty, Lassie. Lassie! Lassie! Where are you going? Lassie! Lassie! Come back! I said I was sorry. I really am. Lassie! Please! Please come back, Lassie! Oh!
out, Chipper. Ah! Cut it out, pretty boy. Cut it out, pretty boy.
Ah! Chipper! Chipper, what are you doing? You naughty little imp. Get back in your cage this instant. Now stop it. Go on. Go on. Chipper, where are you going? What are you doing? Chipper! Chipper, come here. Chipper! 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 Chipper!
Chipper! Chipper, you catch your death of cold.
Chipper, that Lassie didn't... Oh, that Lassie didn't leave you here, you know that? You're a good dog, Lassie. Now, you see, Lassie, Chipper's really trying to be friends.
Seth.
Should have seen Pretty Baby.
Just look, Bertha. First prize winners.
They're beautiful. But now let the poor things out so as they can stretch their legs.
That's my wife for you. Next thing you know, she'll be talking to them.
And you little imp. Oh, you're all ready to go back to the store.
I think she's telling us she's ready to go home.
How was our girl?
Oh, an angel. A positive angel.
Didn't I tell her she'd be good?
I think Lassie had just as nice a time right here.
Oh, I'm sure she did. We had a lot of things to keep us busy, didn't we, Lassie?
Thank you, Bertha. Do come see us soon, will you?
Well, I'll try.
Bye.
Thanks for the ride, Paul.
Bye-bye, Lassie. Good doggy. Bye-bye, Lassie. Good dog.
You're better than good. You're the best dog that anybody ever had.